Hi, I'm Wendy Dubo. I am the Director of Evaluation at the National Center for Women in Information Technology, or NCWIT. And I'm going to talk to you right now about evaluation. So, in making this presentation for you, I decided that rather than have a distracting talking head in the corner while I present these slides, I'll give you a visual to keep you company for the 10 minutes or so it'll take to get through them. These photos were all taken at our NCWIT annual summit. I was probably talking about evaluation in this one. It looked like I'm making a really good point. And then I seem to be talking about something that struck me as nonsense. Here I'm captured looking down beneficently on some thorny discussion that some faculty were having. Then one of my evaluations made national news while I was backpacking at the beach. I'm joking. One of my friends actually made that in Photoshop for my birthday one year. I thought it was cute. Anyway, choose your narrator image and off we go. NCWIT encourages all of our member organizations to make changes in a strategic manner. To facilitate that, we offer strategic change models for each sector. You can see that in this academic strategic change model, evaluation and tracking are a critical piece of strategic change. Let's talk about why. But before we do, I want to make sure that we start off with a shared definition of evaluation, since the term means different things to different people. I like this definition best: the systematic application of social science research procedures for assessing the conceptualization, the design, the implementation, and the utility of social interventions. This came from a textbook, actually, and I really appreciate the way they defined it. So now, to why would we evaluate? I'm a professional evaluator, so of course I think evaluation is critical. But I understand that for others, that intervention is your actual passion. Evaluation can sometimes seem like an add-on. Even though it may entail some extra work, though, evaluation can serve you. You can track what you've done and what effects it has had. We would call these your inputs and your outputs. By monitoring these, you can improve your intervention and find out if you're achieving your objectives. Also, at one time or another, we're all in the position to justify our work, and that is really hard to do without data. Evaluation data can also help you secure future funding, regardless of whether or not your specific intervention worked. In fact, evidence that it didn't work can justify trying something new. So don't be afraid to find out more about the effectiveness of what you're doing. So more specifically, how does evaluation help? The basic questions that evaluation answers are, did we achieve our objectives, and is this worth repeating? Evaluation differs from research in that you're not trying to generalize about all programs like yours, but just provide data about your specific program or activity. So because of this lack of generalizability, evaluations typically don't require IRB approval or Institutional Review Board approval. But you should check with the IRB at your institution, as guidelines definitely differ around the country and around the world. And in any case, regardless of whether you go through IRB, you should respect confidentiality of your respondents and collect data ethically and in as unbiased and unintrusive a manner as possible. So your first step is going to be to identify your goals. What do you want to achieve and what do you want to know? And those form your evaluation questions. The next step is to identify what will help you know if your efforts have made a difference. And because we're all busy people, there's no need to reinvent the wheel. Find out what data sources already exist or what data is already being collected by others at your institution or in your department that could help you answer your evaluation questions. The third step is to collect data, of course. So here I'm calling attention to a few really great resources to help you with your data collection. First, your institutional research office. There's one of these on almost every campus, large or small, They collect data on all students, including major, demographics, degree completion. They also have departmental level data, which others in your department may already have requested, so ask around. Now, you may find that you need to write a survey for your evaluation. While it may seem like anyone can write a survey, there's actually quite a lot of science behind a good survey. So it's a good idea to start with some that have been field tested or validated. Here are three repositories for you to know about. The first one up in the upper right-hand corner of this slide, csedresearch.org. It's a site that contains survey instruments compiled by Dr. Adrian Decker and Dr. Monica McGill, and it pulls from publications in ACM journals. Most of these surveys were used with K-12 populations, so it'll be ideal for you if you're doing an outreach activity. Below that, the evaluation tools at NCWIT. This website contains field-tested and some validated surveys. It also has observation protocols, interview scripts, and checklists covering events and classroom climate and the freshman entry survey I'm going to talk about a little bit later. So it's a really rich resource. And then over on the left bottom corner, the Online Evaluation Resource Library comes out of SRI, which is a well-established evaluation company. And this website contains a large collection of evaluation plans, reports, and instruments from actual evaluations, along with some guidelines for how to improve practice. So, because I helped develop the NCWIT resource, I'm going to walk you through it very briefly. These are screen captures from the website, and you see on the left, we ask you, what are you evaluating? That's the first page you'll see. And the next column is, from whom are you getting data? And then when you choose among those, you get sent to the list of resources that we have on there. So for instance, if you want to know if your talks at freshman orientation are increasing the number of students taking your intro CS classes, then you're doing a post-secondary intervention. And you want to hear from post-secondary students. So the post-secondary intervention is the third block down on the left, the purple one. And then you see you choose post-secondary students rather than faculty. On the other hand, if you're doing a summer camp program for rising seniors in high school, you're doing a K-12 outreach effort. That's the fourth block down, the orange. And you want to hear from K-12 students. Now, you may also want to hear from the staff or students you send out to do that outreach effort, and so we have an instrument about that too. But in any case, you choose what you're evaluating, from whom you're getting data, and then you get sent to the list of instruments available on our site, and you can select which ones might pertain to you. You can use all or part of the instruments. We just ask that if you publish on any of this, you would, or present, you would reference NCWIT and say this is where you got them. Your next step is to analyze your data. For survey data or other quantitative data, those of us in the evaluation field tend to use SPSS or R, but Excel is really powerful too. For qualitative data from interviews or focus groups, you may need dedicated software like Deduce, which is a cloud-based analytical software program. It's great if you are working with partners remotely, or Invivo if you're doing it yourself. But for open-ended responses on a survey, you could code in Excel, and that would be great. If evaluation seems daunting, don't despair. There are people out there who can do it quickly and easily for you. Someone who knows what they're doing will be worth the money it will cost you and the time it will save you. You can hire someone at an hourly or a project rate. If your intervention is funded by an external source, just write a line item in your budget for external evaluation. Your funders will appreciate it. So I've given you a couple of ideas here for how you would find a professional evaluator. The first place I would go would be the American Evaluation Association. It's an international professional association for evaluators, and they have a directory on there of specialties and geographic area and that sort of thing. But if you're on a campus, you could also ask at your education or sociology department. Quite often, faculty or graduate students there have experience in evaluation and can help. Finally, you'll want to build in time to reflect on your data. So many times I see people put a lot of effort into their program or their intervention. They collect data, but they never analyze those data. Or if they do analyze them, they quickly report on them, but they don't stop to reflect how these findings might influence next steps. How can you improve your intervention? What can you do differently, and what should stay the same? And even if your program was very well received, did it actually get you any closer to your diversity goals? If not, what can you do that will accelerate change or progress? That's it for now. Thanks for listening.